Je suis venu vous voir.
C'est comme Noël.
Je vous marque.
Vous voulez le poste de Monsieur Molcaire. Vous voulez le poste de Monsieur Molcaire.
Ah, maman, là, ce problème-là, je ne parle pas de ça, là.
Mm-hmm. What are you doing here?
Voilà.
What are you doing here?
No, I came because Harder is in the Senate.
Yeah.
And he had invited me and Joe Clark because he had come into the government with Joe. But he was a deputy minister for me. He happened to work in the same firm than I, and we had the door next door. So he wanted to meet in the gallery, and I was there with Joe.
Mm-hmm. Est-ce que vous êtes aussi venu rencontrer M. Trudeau?
Ben, M. Trudeau a su que j'étais dans la bâtisse, puis il a eu la gentillesse de m'inviter. Alors, je suis allé voir mon bureau que j'avais occupé pendant 10 ans et que je n'avais pas visité depuis 12 ans et 4 mois.
Qu'est-ce que vous pensez du fait qu'une ministre ne parle que français à Ottawa? Est-ce que c'est un problème pour vous?
Non, je vais vous conter un incident. J'étais devenu ministre des Finances. Et puis, je suis allé au Fonds monétaire international et à la Banque mondiale à Washington. J'ai dit, il n'y a jamais eu... J'ai fait tout mon discours. Il y avait la traduction. J'avais fait tout mon discours en France. Et ça avait été surprenant à Toronto. J'avais eu un peu de merde pour ça, mais j'ai dit, écoutez, si on toujours été en anglais, moi, j'en ferais en français. Je l'ai fait.
Mais vous avez appris l'anglais.
Un peu.
Mais est-ce que c'est...
Il n'y a eu que moi et Maurice Chevalier qui avons eu à pratiquer pour garder l'accent français en anglais.
Mm-hmm. Est-ce qu'il faut absolument parler anglais quand on est ministre à Ottawa?
Ouais, c'est plus utile. Ouais. Mais il y en a qui ne parlent pas français non plus. Alors, c'est mieux, le bilinguisme. Dans un pays comme le nôtre, il y a des choses comme celle-là.
Mais dans la mesure où il y a des gens qui ne parlent pas, des ministres qui ne parlent pas français, est-ce que c'est correct qu'il y ait des ministres qui ne parlent pas anglais?
Ben oui, ils survivent. Alors, il y a des gens gentils qui peuvent traduire. Il y en a qui sont mieux de s'exprimer dans leur langue parce qu'ils peuvent se causer des problèmes s'ils ne sont pas familiers avec l'autre langue. Alors, moi, ça m'est arrivé à quelques reprises, mais ça a été amusé.
So how would you handle this Attawapiskat crisis? You were Indian Affairs Minister. Attawapiskat, the First Nations and all the problems.
I know. It's terrible. You know, I was a minister longer than anybody else. I was there 6 years, 2 months. 3 days and a few hours. So I know the problem. It takes time. But the problem is isolation, and you know, it's difficult to have economic activities in some of these areas. When I quit politics in 84, a few years, I kept working with the natives. I went to northern Manitoba. And you know, it's extremely difficult to have a life there. But they are traditional, they want to be close to the land. They are nostalgic about the past when they were going hunting and fishing, and it takes time. You know, when I was minister, I think the first year there was about a dozen Indians who graduated from university. Now it's thousands and thousands. It takes time. As I was in Old Crow one day, the first machine they ever seen was an helicopter. And they saw the man landing on the moon about the same time. While us, took us centuries to go from the buggy to the man on the moon. So we have to be patient and try to solve the problems.
But you'd leave them there, right? And put resources in, or you move
But the
them,
problem
or?
Is sometimes you cannot. You know, people have to move sometimes. So it's desirable to stay if they want to stay, but it's not always possible. So you cannot have a statement that is generic. You know, it's extremely difficult. It's one case at a time. And it's difficult culturally for them all the time. And I was there with them, for nights. And imagine me speaking to them in my English. They needed a translator to translate my English into English, and after that, to translate that into native language.
Was it lost in translation?
There was a meeting. We were finished at 4 o'clock in the morning. I enjoy it.
How do you think Mr. Trudeau's doing?
He's doing very well.
What do you like about what he's doing?
Well, he's doing it well. He's doing it right. You know, he has the right values, and apparently he meets you once in a while.
Do you think that's a big difference?
I don't know. It's for you. For me, some of you were telling me. months ago that you were missing me because of that.
Vous dites qu'il fait un bon travail. Qu'est-ce que vous aimez de ces six premiers mois?
Excellent travail. Ben oui, mais écoutez, vous savez, le leadership en politique, c'est de créer une atmosphère dans le pays. Un premier ministre, il ne peut pas régler tout. Il ne peut pas. Comment il voudrait, il ne peut pas. Alors, il crée la bonne atmosphère. Quand les gens sont heureux, sont ouverts, sont fiers, comme on l'est à ce moment-ci de sa performance, les gens, vous savez, quand on est préoccupé et qu'on a peur, ben, on ne dépense pas. L'économie a besoin de du monde qui a du fun, qui s'achète des autos.
Mais il a passé des années à se retirer d'un déficit et il est racking one up.
Yes, but we have now, because of me, we have the lowest debt rate of any people in the G7. When I was prime minister, we were defeated only by Italian. So, but now is the time to do it. I wrote him a memo before the campaign. Well, I recommend that to him.
Really?
Of course.
After trying to get rid of the deficit for like years, and you told him to.
Yeah, but you know, we liberals, we proved that when we need to balance the book, we can do it. We've done it.
Alors, les déficits, for 10 years in a row.
But sometimes deficits are needed. You know, you don't pay all your house cash. And when you need infrastructure, you know, the bridge will be there, the building will be there for 50 years. And in our system, we pay always cash.
But what goes up has to come down. How do you get rid of it?
No, you know, debt exists for virtually most of the country in the world. It is the level of the debt. When I was prime minister, when I took over, it was 35 cents in every tax dollar that was going for the payment on the interest. Mm-hmm. Okay? And now it's 10. So it's much easier for stuff for me. 11.5% interest rate, 11%, 11.5% unemployment. But despite of that, I had infrastructure program because I needed jobs. Any balancing, we managed to balance the books 3 years later.
But they don't have oil revenues coming in.
At my time, there was no big oil revenue like it was after. Mm. But they did well when I was prime minister in Alberta.
Donc, les déficits, c'est
better than they did with the Tories.
Mais vous ne récompensez pas tellement. Que pensez-vous de ce qui est arrivé à M. Mulcair en fin de semaine et le fait qu'il
Ben écoutez, c'est malheureux, c'est triste pour lui, mais c'est la vie politique. C'est un métier dur. Et là, moi, j'étais chanceux. Vous gagnez, mais pas tout le monde qui gagne.
Êtes-vous surpris de Bill Energy use?
C'est un problème pour les NPD, c'est un problème, M. Mulcair. Moi, c'est pas pour régler les problèmes des NPD. Moi, je suis un libéral, vous savez. Ça va bien. Alléluia.
Mais vous avez été chef.
La fusion se trompe chaque jour. Vous allez revenir demain.
Vous avez besoin de moi demain encore.
Can you just tell us what you think of the state of the NDP and Thomas Mulcair's position?
Well, it is a problem for the NDP, it is a problem for Mr. Mulcair. You know, when you're in public, it's difficult. He's a man who devoted a lot of his life to public life, but, you know, he didn't win. So what can we do?
What about the suicide crisis in Attawapiskat?
But I said that it's an extremely difficult problem. I was with this problem in 1968, a long time ago. It takes time and patience, and there's always tragedies of that nature that occur, and the government has to do its best to cure it. But it's not easy. You know, it's a big difficulty for them. You know, when I quit politics in 84, came back a few years later, I spent a lot of time visiting reserve in northern Manitoba and Saskatchewan. And it was extremely difficult in that time. It's difficult. There's no economic base there for having jobs and so on, and sometimes they have to move, like anybody else.
Well, who should move then? Like, you mean like move out of Wapiskat, or which reserve?
I don't know.
Should move?
You look at each case. Mm-hmm. Each case. But some people have to move.
Oh, some people, not
if
the
some,
reserve.
Some want to take your job, they have to come to Ottawa.
Exactly.
Yeah.
What do you think of the Energy's pipeline, sir?
No, merci. I have nothing to do with politics anymore. Have a good time, guys.
Are you at the meeting?